Keep watching Charis TV.
When we were praying, I was looking at that lady. Sister, lift up your hands. You who's wearing blue, lift up your hands. I want to stretch my hand to you. And after I stretch my hand to you, you'll get a job. 2021 is your year.
Amen.
You'll get a job.
Amen.
Are you hearing me?
Amen.
I'm saying 2021 is your year.
Amen.
And this job, after you get it, you'll get a car. I don't know about other people, but 2021 is your year. There's no way. A job is coming. Because I wish I can tell her who's doing this. You know, one day I had a pastor. I don't know if he was a pastor or what. He was saying, prophets will always tell you that in your family is the one that is witching you. In my heart, I said, this one is not a pastor, this one. Because if you're a pastor, you'll realize that you'll read the Bible. Jesus said, I'll bring fire. Two will stand against one. You'll realize that your own brother will stand against you. Not even your auntie. You hear what I said? Not even your auntie. Your auntie is very far. If your own brother can stand against you, what about your auntie? Your auntie will finish you off. We're not promoting that families must divide. No. You see what is happening when we speak about this? We are not promoting that families must do what? Must divide. No. But you will never have an enemy that is far from you. It's impossible. What happened to Cain and Abel? Huh? Perfect example. What happened to Cain and Abel? He killed his own brother. Jealousy. Why do you think they will leave you? Your own blood will show you that we don't know you. You heard, brother? Never think an enemy is someone who's far from you. If you've got an enemy that is far, you created that for yourself. I'm saying this because of that lady. I'm saying if I tell her the person who's doing this, I'm sure she won't sleep. Let me stretch my hand to you. In Jesus' mighty name. Your spiritual husband, come out. Come out. Spiritual husband, come out. Out, you demon. Out. Sir, where is your mom? You? That one. Where is your mom?
She's in Venda.
You must pray for your mom, eh?
Okay.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
I'm seeing the feet of your mom.
She's complaining about them every day.
Yes.
When I call her.
Give glory to God.
Help me, man of God.
No. I'm not going to help you. Because I don't know you. I'm seeing for the first time. I say, where's your mom? We must pray for the feet of your mom because this is like high blood. Oh,
yes,
you know what I mean?
Yes, she's having high blood.
Yeah, she's developing high blood. But this high blood is traveling here on her feet.
Yes.
That's why always when you call her, it's like I was hearing you when you were speaking on the phone.
That's true. Yes. Every now and then when I call her, she tells me about it.
That's the problem she tells you about all the time.
Yeah.
That my feet.
Yeah.
I'm praying that God must save your mom.
Okay, sir.
Oh,
thank
you. In Jesus' mighty name. And where is your wife?
My wife, she's in Venda. So I was supposed to go and fetch her to be with me this side. So only that they closed while I was break. So she's working as a teacher. So the very weekend that they closed, then I was starting my work. I must start my shift.
You must pray for your marriage.
Okay, sir.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, it's under the rock. Yes, true.
You must pray for your marriage. I'm seeing something that I don't want to say it here.
Okay, sir.
You understand?
Okay, sir.
I don't want to say it here. Put your life straight.
Okay, sir.
And fix your marriage, and I believe God will help you.
Thank you so very much.
Jesus' name. Out! You demon! Out, you demon! Out! Bring him here. Put something there. Name of Jesus. Jesus' name. And if you ask this man, he will tell you, I'm doing this for the first time. Sir, you must pray. Yeah? Are you hearing me? You must pray.
Amen.
You must be careful of accident.
Amen.
Are you hearing me?
Amen.
Satan wants to kill you with accident.
Yes, yes.
You remember what happened?
Yeah, yes.
Huh?
Yes, I remember.
Huh?
Yes. 1998.
Yeah. This
so
question. Now, in Jesus' mighty name. Because the same spirit that caused accident is the one that is making you to be like this. You don't have anything in your hands.
Yes, yes.
And you have worked so hard. But there's nothing in your hands.
Yes, yes.
The accident of 1998. So the reason I'm saying, be careful, because same spirit wants to come back now and cause another one, but this time it will be reversed from where it's coming from. Mama, can you do business? Are you hearing me? Can you do business?
Yes.
Because believe in the business of clothes also.
That is the business I'm doing.
That's the business you're doing now?
Yes.
Yeah, because I'm seeing clothes. And I'm also seeing you. I see you going to Durban.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
I'm seeing you in a bus. Huh?
Yes.
You buy your clothes there.
Some other clothes, I buy them there.
You buy them in Durban?
Yes.
Because I'm seeing a bus, and the bus is going to Durban. And I'm hearing that's where you're going to, you buy clothes from.
Amen.
And I believe your business will grow, Mama.
Amen.
Your business will grow. In Jesus' name. Come on. Jesus' mighty name. Where are your children? Where are your children?
Where are my children?
Yeah.
I have one that is alive. She's in Eastern Cape.
Bring him. Mama, where are your children?
I have one that is alive. She's in Eastern Cape.
Don't cry. You want a child?
Yes.
Huh? Is your husband?
Yes.
Come, sir. Are you away? It's not fine. Are you aware that he's not fine? Are you aware that they're attacking him? You're not aware. Say, I'm not aware.
I'm not aware.
Now I'm telling you. Are you hearing me? You want a child?
Yes, I want.
When?
Now.
Sir, do you want a child?
Yes, I want.
Huh? Huh?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure. But we have a problem, that's why I come for you.
I know. Listen, you people are meeting you for the first time. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
And I come to you and say, do you want a child? I know your problem.
Please help us.
No, I'm not going to help you. Jesus Christ will help you.
Amen.
I'm not in a position of helping people. My job is to pray for you, and God, the living God, will do the rest.
Amen.
I'm just doing my part, because I'm seeing this lady crying a lot. And the child is nowhere to be found. So now, the child must come now.
Amen.
You see this attack that is here?
Yes.
It will leave you today.
Amen.
This thing that the doctors told you,
yes.
Say you've got a fibroid here, and you've got some things that are developing here, they are leaving you today.
Amen.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
And this man is not sick also. Maybe you'll understand late. And I'm praying that this marriage must never break.
Amen.
You hear what I said?
Yes, sir.
The marriage must not break.
Let it be so.
Because you know what is happening now. This marriage is at the brink. In fact, you people, when I'm praying for you, I'm not seeing marriage.
Yes.
Know what you said, man of God.
You understand me?
Yes.
When I'm praying for you, I'm not seeing marriage. I'm seeing court. That's what I'm seeing.
We're separated. We just come together.
Recently, November.
Give glory to God.
Amen.
Because when I'm praying for you, the minute I lay my hand, like I had, there's no marriage. And now, this marriage is fixed today, and God must give you a child.
Amen.
I don't want to say many things. You know what happened.
I know, man.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, man.
You know what happened.
Yes.
Are you hearing me?
Yes,
ma'am. The reason why you stopped the marriage. Are you hearing me?
Yes, ma'am.
We can't talk about that.
Yes, ma'am.
You know there was a spirit.
I know, ma'am.
That was making people to be unfaithful.
Yes.
Huh?
Big many times, man of God.
Yes. So I'm saying there was a spirit that was making people to be unfaithful to each other. So
yes.
Now that's the reason why. So now, it was God who brought you back together again.
Amen.
So your house is delivered.
Yes. To your
brother, you'll be a lawyer very soon.
Amen.
Are you hearing me? You'll be a lawyer very soon, and after they hire you, you'll bring a car here.
Amen.
You know what I mean? A car that will speak by itself.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
And the house, you remember you built a house and the wind came.
Yes, I remember.
And the wind took the house. So now any wind that will come this time, I reverse it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because how do you build a house and a wind comes? And the whole house will boom. I mean, there must be Satan somewhere. How do you build a house and the wind comes, brother, and takes the house? According to me, I wish you can how many rooms you're building?
It was one, but it was an extension.
It was an extension from the house?
Yes.
Extended with 5 more rooms again.
Amen.
Because you'll see Satan will keep quiet now.
Amen.
I'm telling you. Satan will keep quiet.